Do gather round him all you saints, and raise a cheerful voice unto your King, and also praise him with exalted noise. With shouts rejoicing earnestly, to lift your hands up high, that all around the nations may witness your joyous cry, that all the way unto heaven your shouts of joy are heard, and that the lowest depths of earth do get to hear his word. And every living thing between would hear it for themselves, the beauty and the majesty of our God's flowing wells. His living waters, flowing springs that from his temple flow, out of the midst of Mount Zion down to the world below. The living water of the Word of God, as it does wash away the sins of all the world, and by his blood be bought, that flows out from the belly of all those his blood has bought. As living waters of the Word within them Christ has wrought, and Christ is building this temple from lively stones of them. Fountains come forth out of God's house, flow from Jerusalem. These living waters that come forth out from the soul and heart of all those that have found in him his beauty's gracious art. All those that have found him will shout, also whisper in peace of living waters that come forth his living words release. Of all that he has given us, and all that we have heard from our Father in heaven that has given us his word, the living word of truth that is to be the Word made flesh, sent down to us, and that we would be one. The bread of life sent from heaven, this manna are we fed upon the flesh of Christ Jesus, and by our shepherd led. The sheep found in him will rejoice for their place in the sun, that they may show unto the world what their shepherd has done. This is the refreshing he would subject the world unto, but they would not do or listen, or by his flood break through the veil of the flesh, veil of his body. This breaking being unto death, and by his suffering all glory, praise, and honor to the name of Christ Jesus. For by his covenant with them, redemption wrought in us. This work Christ has begun in them, this too a living hope, that he would unto them be wed, and with their soul elope. For I am jealous for you with a godly jealousy, that I have betrothed you to one husband that I may give. To Christ as innocent and clean, to him dedicated, wed to him in simplicity, that you not be deceived, nor beguiled or vexed by them that complicate their lives. Submitting to Christ's lowliness in humble sacrifice, we are the temple, he the place and land in which we live, issuing forth his living word of his creation give. He is the land of promise for all them who dwell in him, the one hope for all of the world that look to him from sin. This land of promise is Israel. Christ is this land for us, the promised land of Israel, and Christ is this promise. The promise of our hope in him unto eternity, that by the covenant we share, do bind ourselves with he. As partners we do walk with him, and share in his sorrows. For he's acquainted with our grief, all of our tomorrows. Firsthand he knows our sufferings, that's why he came to die. He is the lover of our soul, this is the reason why. Jealous that he is not willing to share his children's love, nor those that he himself purchased with his own precious blood. So gather around all you saints, with your voice touch the sky, and give to him all of your praise with love from your heart's cry. And give rejoicing thanks unto the everlasting King. His righteousness is forever, unto his praises sing. And from eternity unto eternity always, all your attention to him give, his grace and beauty praise. Nor let yourself be divided by person, place, or thing. Then you become his precious jewel, you with him will he bring.